everyone. Good afternoon. Welcome to the conference. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit today about why you should think voice first for smart devices. So let me introduce myself. My name is Sohan. I work in the Alexa team in Amazon. My job involves speaking at conferences, doing technical workshops, and generally talking a little bit about going voice first. So let's take a bit of a step back. This is an image I think most of us would have seen. We would have seen it at posters or on your phone wallpaper or on your t-shirt. It's an image called the March of Progress, and it basically talks about how we've evolved from, you know, ape to being able to walk on 2 feet, to be able to master tools, to being able to master machines. Right? This is an image I think all of us have seen. A lot of us would have seen this, which is a sort of next natural progression about how we are all, you know, hunched over looking at our mobile phones. If you really look at how we have interacted with personal technology, it dates to about maybe about 40 years, right? And it all started in the mid-1970s when we started using personal technology. We started interacting with tech where we did something called character mode, where there was this monitor, there was this keyboard, and you entered text-based commands, and something happened, right? Like the terminal that us as programmers use nowadays. That was in the mid-1970s. Things changed a bit in the mid-1980s, where we finally moved to graphical user interfaces, which were interfaces that were graphical in nature. So for the first time, you could see a file on your system. You could move this piece of hardware around that would translate to the screen, which was your computer mouse. So as things evolved, we also, you know, in the mid-90s, we moved to the era of the web, the World Wide Web, where for the first time, you could actually get information on your fingertips. To access that information, of course, you had to use this thing called a browser. And this looks like a fairly young crowd, but I at least remember using Netscape Navigator and Internet Explorer. You know, it took like 5 minutes for a static web page to load, but things have of course changed. In the mid-2000s is I think something we're all very familiar with, which is the age of the mobile phone, right? And that's the image that you see the far right of the screen. And essentially, in the era of the mobile phone, just look at the amount of change we've seen in the last 20 years or so, right? We've gone from really basic phones with small screens, black and white screens, clunky keypads, to the advanced smartphones that we use today, that all of us use today. And think of the sort of interactions you have on your phone right now. Yeah, you swipe right, you pull to refresh. How do you zoom a page on your phone? Yeah, you do that, pinch to zoom. So in the short span of time, you can see that as tech evolves, so does how we interact with technology. As if on time, sometime in the mid-2010s, I think this paradigm shifted again, finally, to the age of voice user interfaces. As humans, I think speaking comes naturally to us. We communicate with each other via speech. A baby's first words is such a big deal. But we haven't really been able, up until this point, to talk to machines and hear an intelligent response back. Yeah? And in this image, the next sort of phase of evolution is for us to be able to talk to machines and hear intelligent responses. Yeah, and you might think, hey, why didn't we just start with this? Why only now? Because we as humans, we use speech, right? Why did we start with this? Well, the reason was it wasn't that easy. Only now we are at a stage where speech recognition is comparable to that of a human. Typically, we as humans, we have about 95% speech recognition. And now with the advanced algorithms we have, and you know, of course, a whole bunch of other things had to fall into place. You know, we have cloud computing, and we have access to data, we have the machine learning, we have the AI. All of that sort of came together for us to be able to use voice to communicate with machines. We at Amazon, we truly believe that voice represents the next major disruption in computing. Now, I'm sure you guys have heard this word a lot, disruption. Right? It's where a new piece of technology or a new product or a new platform, it really changes how we operate or how we behave. And when it comes to computing, we truly believe that voice is that next major disruption. And it's not just us, you know. The statistics also will show that. We saw this disruption happen, right? We saw this disruption, this huge change happen, which was when we came up with the Amazon Alexa. Right? And this is just a snapshot of few products that are enabled by Amazon Alexa, and I'll talk a little bit about that in a while. Let's just take a look at some of the statistics as well, right? And as you can see here, just take a look at the number of smart device shipments that are expected to be sold by 2022. There's like a 39% annual growth rate in the number of smart device shipments that are going to be sold by the year 2022. Yeah? Okay. Sorry. Can you hear me now? Better? Audible? Yeah? Check, check. Is it audible now? I'll just speak a little better. Yeah. All right. Yeah. As I was saying, if you can just take a look at the number of smart device shipments that are expected to be sold by 2022. And just take a look at the number of worldwide searches that are via voice. Right? As you can see, we launched Amazon Alexa sometime in mid-2015, late 2015 actually. And you can see the number of searches that have exponentially increased. And by 2020, it's expected to be over 200 billion searches. So as you can see, voice is everywhere, right? People are using voice. A recent survey even said that a quarter of American households now have like a smart speaker in their house. Yeah, which is a stunning number given that this whole thing just started very, very recently. So, like I said, at Amazon, we really believe that voice is that next major disruption in computing. And our idea is not just to be able to just talk to like this one machine via voice. Our idea is really for Alexa to be everywhere, right? So that means, the quick question, does anyone have an Alexa-enabled device at your house, few of you? Okay, that's awesome, nice, cool. The guys from Amazon, of course, have Alexa devices. But our real idea is for Alexa everywhere, which means you're talking to these machines at your home. You know, you have maybe a couple of Echo devices in your home. You're talking to Alexa on the go, you know, maybe Bluetooth-enabled headphones that you're using that are voice-controlled, and even at your workplace. Yeah, so this is really our vision for Alexa, which is to sort of Alexa to be everywhere. We frequently talk about this thing called ambient computing, which is, if you ask me, the future, where you don't really have, you're not really limited by the range of motion of your hand. Right now, we have the sum of all human knowledge at our disposable through our mobile phone, but you're really limited by the range because you have to pick up your mobile phone to really do something. Yeah, but with Alexa and with ambient computing and with Alexa everywhere, you really are not limited by that. Just some stats though. Alexa is supported in about 14 countries right now and multiple languages. So it's not just English, you have German, you have Japanese, French, Italian, and Spanish. We have 150 plus products that are Alexa built in, and we have 28,000 plus products that work with Alexa. We also have 80,000 plus Alexa skills, and I'll just get back to that in the next slide. And most importantly, we have hundreds of thousands of developers really working on building skills and on building products with Alexa. Yeah, so that is really exciting for us because I frequently do workshops in all over India basically, and the response I see from people who have already built great skills or who have already built great products for Alexa, it's simply mind-blowing. So I spoke a little bit about skills. So what is a skill for Alexa? Essentially, a skill on Alexa is kind of like an app on your phone. Yeah? So how typically when you buy a new phone, the first thing you do is to download an app. Yeah, and an app really enhances the capabilities of your phone. So similarly,